Hello, Miss Frost and I are here at Shingle Street today, which is on the Suffolk coast between Felixstowe and Aldborough. And you can see some of our fieldwork equipment's already in the shingle there, ready to go. So we're here to collect some data from the beach, as is hopefully fairly obvious. It's a great place to be. It's an isolated location. It's remote. It is British coastal wilderness at its best. It feels very frontier-like. The sun is shining. We've got some lovely clouds, fair weather clouds in the sky, and all is well. It's also a place of great secrecy and legend. During World War II, there were stories about Ministry of Defence cover-ups, burnt German bodies of German soldiers on the beach being found here. Certainly a fascinating place. Today we're going to be collecting some data, doing some beach profiles, pebble sizes and roundness as we move up the beach away from the sea. That ultimately will be used for Spearman rank correlation to see if there is a significant relationship between two sets of data. So a possible null hypothesis we might use once we get back to the classroom will be there is no relationship between distance up the beach and mean pebble size at Shingle Street. To be continued. Okay, hello, I'm back from the beach for part two of this video. So this is a Spearman's rank correlation we're going to do on some of this data. Now, a Spearman's rank correlation is a statistical test to see whether there is a significant relationship between two sets of data. We need at least 10 pairs, which I've done here. Preferably, we would use more. But for the purposes of this demonstration, we'll just use 10. Now, this is a three-stage process going through doing a Spearman rank correlation. First of all, we need to state a null hypothesis, and that's written here. That is that there is no significant relationship between the distance from the sea and the pebble size at Shingle Street. We then, once we've worked out what the data is, we then do some things with it, be able to calculate the Spearman's rank correlation coefficient using this formula, which is a lot less intimidating than it at first looks to some people. And then we then think about whether what that result means once we find the number. So first job is, when we're doing this, we need to think about ranking our data. Now, in the first instance, distance from the sea in meters, this is really quite straightforward. We just rank from largest to smallest. So I can just go, because these are at clear intervals, I can just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, very straightforward, I've ranked those numbers. And then I need to rank the pebble size in this column here. So slightly more complex, but nothing too complicated, hopefully. So we go, okay, biggest number right is down the bottom, so that's number one there. Second biggest would be 4.4. Third biggest is there. Fourth biggest, number one there. Then we've got to go down to 3.2. Then I've got to go all the way up to the top, yeah, for number six. Seventh, eighth, and then nine, and rank 10. Okay, having done that, very simply then we do difference between the ranks. So 10 minus six, for example. Okay, so we go, that's gonna be four, and then we've got one, that's gonna be minus two, minus four, six minus 10 is minus four, five minus five is zero, four minus three gives us one, that's going to be minus one, that's going to be one, and that's going to be minus one. Okay, easy peasy. Then, also pretty straightforward, is that we are going to square those numbers. So that's going to be 16, and then we can go, yep, one squared, of course, is one, four, that's 16 as well, then we've got zero, we've got, then one, and one. Okay, now, all those numbers in that column, all we now need to do is to add those up, and that's going to give us, let me just check that number on my calculator, that is, doesn't really need one, does it? That's going to be 42. There we go. So that's the most difficult number to work out, not that it was difficult, and then we put that number into here and we then work it through. So pretty straightforward, hopefully. So we're going to go RS, which is the which means Spearman rank, is going to be 1 minus, and then we've got 6. And then this is the sum of D squared, which we know is 42. So 6 lots of 42 there, over N is the number of pairs of data that we've got. So N is going to be, that's going to be 10. 10 squared minus 1. There we go. Okay, so we need to work that through. So again, one more time. 1 minus, and then we're going to do 6 times 42 gives us, 6 times 42 is 252 over, so 100 minus 1, so 99 times 10 gives us 990. Okay, so we work that through. I'm just going to S equals 1 minus, and then that's going to be minus 0.254, which then we just need to do 1 minus that number then. So that means we do, let's go up here, equals, that's going to be 0.746 roughly. Okay, there we go. That is the answer. Easy peasy. Now, if the number that we come up with is going to be more than 1 or is less than minus 1, then something's gone wrong. We've made a mistake in the calculation. It's got to be it's going to have to be between minus 1 and plus 1. Okay, and if we've got 0 in the middle and we've got plus 1 up this end and we've got minus 1 down that end, that is where we're going to look for. Now, we're interested in where on that spectrum between minus 1 and plus 1 this number falls. And of course, 0.746, that's going to be sort of there. Okay. What we then do is to compare our Spearman rank answer, so this number here, which is obviously that, against critical value at a 95% confidence level. So are we 95% sure that what the answer to our stats test is going to be, our Spearman rank is going to be, is accurate. So this, for the purposes of what we're doing here, we'll use the value of 0.05, which is what we usually get in an exam question. But we would be given a table for that, so you haven't got to worry too much about that. So if our answer is above 0.05 in this case, then what we do is reject this null hypothesis. So that we're saying that is not correct, we're not happy with that. And therefore, we establish that there is a significant relationship between the two variables, i.e. there is a significant, actually it's a positive number, isn't it? So actually this is a significant positive, i.e. as one goes up, the other goes up. There is significant statistical relationship between these two sets of data. So i.e. as the distance from the sea goes up, so does the pebble size, just here, okay? Now that hopefully is useful. So we have established that, and what we can then do is if we're writing a project, an NEA, or we're thinking about it in exam terms and a question, we don't just have to say, well, looking at this, this is what I sort of wrote at the beginning, there seems to be a link, kind of as those numbers go up, yeah, these numbers, yeah, they sort of seem to be going up as well. It's not perfect, but yeah. So rather than just having to analyze this data and say that, I can do better, because I can say, right, having done a Spearman rank correlation coefficient, I can say that statistically, I've said that there is every chance that these two pieces of data are going to correlate, and there is a relationship between these two bits of data. And that makes my analysis of this data much, much stronger. Okay, thank you very much.